Medicine has been traditionally done using small molecules like aspirin or even more recently antibodies. It's mostly focused on symptoms. I'm here today to tell you about this idea of using cells as living drugs to address the root cause of disease. My name is Leo. I did my PhD at Harvard with Jack Strominger and Chad Cowan until 2016, where we were the first to use CRISPR-Cas9 genome editing in human blood cells, blood stem cells, and primary human T cells. And now I'm a postdoctoral scholar with Jeff Bluson and Kizi Tong at UCSF, where I focus on taking this technology into making cell therapies for autoimmune disease. So my first contact with CRISPR was at the end of 2012, back in graduate school, because my program insisted that we present journal club without using PowerPoint in a topic unrelated to your research. So I was a young budding immunologist, so I'm gonna study what? Bacteria. So I picked this bacterial paper, this new thing called CRISPR. This idea that bacteria somehow, they can keep track of what viruses have infected them, keep them in these locus in their genome, and then just like a little book that they keep. When the virus comes a second time, the bacteria sees that sequence, and there's these molecular scissors, the Cas9, that guided by the guide RNA, will then chop up that virus genome. So this was in 2012, and then lo and behold, January 2013, a couple months later, this happened. CRISPR-Cas9 is a revolutionary tool that allows us to edit the human genome at unprecedented efficiencies and very cheap, very easy. And so this timeline is so small, it wouldn't even make sense to prolong this axis. Because in 2013, in January, two papers came out back-to-back in Science, George Church, Fong Zhang at MIT and the Broad Institute, using CRISPR-Cas9 in human cell lines for the first time. That same year, Rolf Janisch across the street was the first to make mouse models using CRISPR. He did a triple knockout in mice, something that was never ever heard of. The next year, in 2014, we were the first to take this technology to primary human blood cells, in this case to develop a new treatment for HIV. Next year, 2015, China edits human embryos for the first time. And they do it again in 2017. And now the United States also in 2017. And then this year, 2018, CRISPR Therapeutics, which is actually co-founded by my former advisor, Chad Cowan, and actually I helped design some of these guide RNAs, is launching the first clinical trial in humans. And Japan is now in talks to decriminalize, actually make it legal to edit human embryos. So 5 years, I barely had time to finish graduate school, and CRISPR went from this bacterial obscure curiosity to the tool that is gonna change medicine. And so you can change any gene you want, like you were in a Word document, but what if I want new genes? Why do I have to limit myself to genes that already exist? What if I can make my own gene? So this is what really gets into the field of chimeric antigen receptors, or CAR T cells. So chimeric, like the Greek mythology, because it can actually take components from different receptors and put them in one at your own will. And so the idea of these receptors is that you can reprogram, you can redirect T cells, so the adaptive arm of your immune system, to recognize and kill cancer cells upon recognition of any surface molecule I want. We're no longer limited to whatever peptide cancers might happen to express that normal cells don't. I can take any surface molecule and insert an antibody component that will then trigger this T cell to kill that tumor. And so that's, you're probably aware, back last year, two therapies were approved using this technology. This therapy is literally a bag of cells that costs $500 million of engineered T cells that will seek and destroy the cancer cells. And actually on Monday was a Nobel Prize for cancer immunotherapy. So that's taken, I should probably work on something else. And so luckily, I'm actually focused on autoimmune disease. So it's easier to destroy than to keep something together. And so what I work on is in autoimmune disease. And so luckily for me, even though the immune system is really seen as an army that keeps us safe, sometimes it goes rogue and destroys our own tissues. But there's a subset of T cells called regulatory T cells. And their job is not to kill other cells, but rather to suppress immune responses. They're like the generals of the immune system. Nothing goes overboard if these Tregs are around. And so what I'm trying to exemplify here is how I'm taking a systematic approach to try different signaling domains, so ways to influence the cells how they make decisions, what they do when they get to their target. And if you can engineer the perfect regulatory T cell, make it a CAR Treg, we can now really have the hope to cure really complex diseases such as autoimmune disease. I focus on type 1 diabetes, where, as you probably know, the pancreas is this gland banana-shaped that makes insulin that allows your cells to take up glucose after your meal. But in type 1 diabetes, there's autoreactive T cells that they somehow escape proper education in the thymus, and they react against your own tissue, and they destroy your pancreas, leading for more glucose in the blood and all sorts of problems. Our goal is to design regulatory T cells, CAR Tregs, that can go to the tissue and suppress this immune response at the site and establish immune tolerance such that we can go back to the normal status. Thank you.